Hey guys, John Kerry, 1963 Jag. So here's Bettie sitting in the garage, back, all in one piece. A little worse for the wear in terms of oil leaking down the back of the motor and out the bottom and making a whole mess under the undercarriage. So I had to spend a little time mopping stuff up in there. But other than that, you know, everything ran pretty well. I was a little worried about my wheels. I posted a little while ago that the centering of the hubs wasn't quite locking the wheels all the way back on the taper that's back behind that hub there, in order to center them and lock them in nice and you know, center it, to center them. And what I did is I drove it a little while, and then I hammered on it and drove it a little while and hammered on it, and the noise that I was hearing, kind of a thunk 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 thunk, thunk at low speed, went away. So and at high speed, of course, you can't really hear it, or maybe it stops because it's moving so fast, I don't know. But anyway, I tightened them up again. Turns out these are MWS wheels that are made in the Dunlop under license in with their design. So this is the new version of the Dunlop wheel. So why they you know, aren't centering and locking in there real nice, I don't know. But there you go, you see the logo on there. That's the MWS logo. So I'm going to dig up the part numbers off the backs of the wheels, see if I can find them today, and then I'm going to write to those guys and ask them if they've got any advice on why that might be happening. Maybe they had a bad run, and who knows, maybe they'll do something good for me. I'm going to post a video in a little while to show you guys the ride we took. We went up to a winery that is built like a castle, and this place was very cool. So we brought home some goodies that, you know, Napa Valley can't go up there and not bring home a little vino. So we came home with a couple of bottles of, a couple of reds and a couple of whites just to have around the house for the holidays. This Reserve Chardonnay was really, really good. Can you read that? Not too well, huh? It's too bright. There we go. That's very, very nice. And then we got, I think, a Pinot Grigio, because I like the taste of that. And I'm kind of into whites. Here's a Cabernet that we got, which is just the 2011. Here's the Pinot Grigio that we got. So that one. And then I think we got one other red that Denise really loves. Yeah, this one here called the Barbera. So, got two whites and two reds. So that's our prize we brought home. We also have a little, what was it, grape oil, I think, or something? I don't know what she buy. Grapeseed oil, lemon-flavored grapeseed oil. So there you go, we had a little souvenir time. But anyway, everything went great. Bettie ran great. I was really thrilled. You know, literally couldn't wipe the smile off my face while I was driving. So stay tuned. You're going to see what it was like to drive up to Napa Valley, and about a 300-mile run. So pretty good for a first outing, maiden voyage. Thanks, guys. Bye. Here's the Casillo Amoroso.
Yeah.
A replica of a 13th century castle. That's a winery up in Napa Valley.
Okay.
Pretty amazing.
Hope we can fit in our little car.
Complete with a moat.
We weren't intending on buying it.
Complete with a moat. I don't know if there's any alligators in there, but there might be.
I don't think so. Great stuff.